Café. Café is a different category. That's why you see Store Ambiance as a numbers third there. They go and have different expectations. Now, a few key success factors for a restaurant. What kind of services GNY expect from them? More payment options came out as a number one, followed by phone reservation and Wi-Fi. What made them try new restaurants? Today, you see new restaurants arising. You can see the word recommendations, whether it is friends, whether it is family, and promotions is there. Now, we look into cafe. Cafe is a little bit more interesting because they include in the point number three online reservations. Today, it may not be so practical, but in the future, I mean, cafes are playing a very important role. It's comfy, it's comfortable, it's a place that people like to mingle. So having these online reservations could be an area for you to explore. Then we have, once again, friends, recommendation, family, and promotions within cafe. Now, moving along within FMCG, confectionery for the brands that are producing these products, confectionery taste is very, very important, critical. Quality and affordability. And you see that the level of brand loyalty is quite high, almost 48, I mean, almost 50%. If you compare this against skincare enjoy a loyalty, brand loyal of 75%, which is expected, but if you don't quantify it, it's very difficult to take actions on this. For skincare, quality, very important. You see the recommendations. Recommendation came in here. And this is another important part. This go pretty much and is consistent across all the different categories and affordability. Lastly, we just include one more, which is carbonated beverage. It has the lowest type of loyalty, 31%. But taste, affordability, and quality are very important criteria for them. So why try to reinvent the bill if GNYs are telling you very loud what matters to them? That's the purpose for us in this study, is to share with you what's really important for them and how you can build your brand. Other insights I mentioned to you about the importance of chemical-free and organic products. Not surprising to see Body Shop and Clinique in the list of top brands there. Female Gen Y tend to make purchases of skincare in department stores, specialty stores. But males tend to be a little bit more practical in their approach, and they buy their skincare in supermarkets, probably as part of their routine activity, nothing to blame. Then, what else? 60, talking about alcohol brands, 64% of Gen Y mentioned that they are willing to try new brands. This is something very special because, at the same time that they are willing to try new brands, they are also very loyal to their brands. Among all the categories, alcoholic brands represent a category that has the highest level of loyalty. But still, they are willing to try new brands. And more than half of them consider alcohol brands for gifting. Gifting came up also as a very interesting trend among Generation Y. So this is, they are living day by day and they are looking for gratification. They are willing to share. So gifting could be a theme on its own for whether you are a retailer or whether you are a brand owner to develop within your product assortment. Additional consideration, 71% do online shopping, pretty much dominated by fashion. Now the question is, okay, people talk about trying goods in the store and then purchasing online. Is it happening? Yes, it is happening. To what degree? Many people say, I don't know, but I know it's happening. So we try to quantify this, and you can see on the chart that across apparel, footwear, and bags, almost 50% of them saying that they will actually go to the store and make purchases. You will see a correlation between what kind of categories they look for information online, and you will see why these categories are having high level of degree. Moving ahead, we believe that even brands within the FMCG sector will be selling, and we can see this in grocery retailers going online and making big bang there. Plenty of opportunities in these channels. In terms of social media habits, I mentioned to you that number one is still Facebook. Instagram is catching up very fast. And in terms of what are the most common brands follow, in social media. You see three fashion brands, two from UK and one from Sweden. We hope to see one Singaporean brand in future. They have a very good level of followers. Now the question is how to get Gen Y to follow you on social media. And we talk about latest products, latest promotions, brands that they like. All is about content. And we come back to this point about having a meaningful brand. You cannot expect to engage a Gen Y without having a meaningful brand, a brand that you are able to talk and are able to respond when they talk to you. So how to get Gen Y to share your posts, make your product content interesting, make them feel that your product deal is worth sharing. All these comments is not coming from us. This is coming from the report. These are some quotes from Gen Y. How frequent will they share personal moments on social media? The highest level is in the category of dining, followed by fashion, and lastly is FMCG. Now, we know that they share their personal moments. The question is, to what degree? So for F&B, 43% of them say that they will they share dining moments with their friends and family. But this is just the first step, because they share this with you. The question is, what will they do with this action? Will your friends react to you and say, okay, that's good? Or will they actually take an action and go and visit the place? So we ask this question, and 50% of them say that they will visit the friend that they friends posted and share with them. This shows a very close correlation in terms of conversion and penetration to your stores, if you know how to manage this properly. Media platforms, we talk about social media. It is happening, yes, it is happening. We have very close SPH friends here. We hope to give you better news, but reality for Straight Times, I mean, reality is that they are consuming a lot of social media and they do a lot of general search online. So you see, whether it is dining, whether it is fashion, whether it is FMCG, when they look for information for the new product launches, new foods to go and eat with their friends, they will go to social media in the first place. So I try to make my presentation short. I know we have overrun a little bit. So I just want to give you these three words for you to keep in mind as a takeaway. Shopping behaviors. One, affordability. Keep in mind that your product must be worth it. Sounds simple, but many people take this for granted. Second impulse, plenty of opportunities for retailers and brand owners also in the grocery stores, how they display their products. Finally, recommendations. Try to drive word of mouth, but do it only if you have the content to support it. So that's my last slide. Thank you.